1971 began with an exciting return to the railway. Sir Eustace Missenden had returned from his overhaul at Mr. Smash's works and was very pleased to be home. He had missed his friends greatly and happily spent his first day back discussing the news. Due to his time at the works, he was already familiar with Caracas Smash, Five and Barry, and despite Barry's apparent insanity, he got on quite well with him. "So, Barry, I heard that Mr. Smash was sending you elsewhere rather than here with us."
"Oh aye, he was. He was planning to send me to Barbados, but I put my foot down and I told him, 'No, you silly tosser. Going somewhere hot would ruin my complexion and could potentially make me break out in horrible sores and head lice.'"
"Well, I'm happy to see you, of course."
"And the world is happy for your existence too. Now then, I think it's time I went and got a nice cup of tea."
Soon, a new fast freight train had been introduced, which was brought to Kolhapa from a nearby docks, and was taken over by a dark railway engine for further transit to Mirkum. The cargo carried by these trains, though, was...
"Chickens?"
"No, Barry, not chickens! Fish!"
"Fish? Don't be daft, Sonny Jim. You can't make good pies out of fish. Unless you're one of those madmen who likes fisherman's pie or admiral's pie or banoffee pie."
"Well, it doesn't involve you anyway, Barry. Myself and Turbo will be taking these trains exclusively, apparently." Barry didn't like the smugness in Raymond's voice.
"Hey, why can't I take those trains? I'm more than capable of handling a few fishy fingers, I am."
"It's probably because it's a late night train, and it's probably easier for a diesel to take these trains."
"Well, I'll soon see about that nonsense. I'll go and show Lord Light that I should be in charge of those poor little fishies."
However, Mr. Dark wasn't convinced. "Look, Barry, I know you like pulling goods trains, but I'd much prefer Raymond and Turbo work them."
"This is racism, this is."
"It's not racism. They're quieter for the late night work, and besides, they are allowed to go beyond Kolhapa to the goods loop to pick up the trains, and steam engines aren't really allowed beyond the station limits, I'm afraid."
"Well, I understand completely, but I'll have you know that I am extremely upset about all this. I'll be writing an angry letter to my local Member of Parliament about all of this. You'll see."
Barry puffed sadly away. Usually, Raymond or Turbo would head down to Kolhapa late in the evening to pick up the fish train, called the Red Herring, which amused the diesel greatly. They would wait at the station for the train to be dropped off, then pick it up, and quickly run it up to Mirkum, where the crates of fish were unloaded and transported elsewhere by vans and lorries. Things were quite normal for a couple of weeks, apart from the bad smell that became associated with the two diesels whenever they ran the train.
"Certainly gives new meaning to the term smelly diesel. We can't help the smell. The trains are important."
"Well, you two could certainly use an air freshener and a wash down when you do take it."
"We do! But the smell of cod and kipper and herring does seem to hang around these long afterwards.
Rather you two than myself, of course. The stench of fish is not benefiting of an engine such as myself."
"Yeah, you two can keep your stinky fish trains."
But one night, something unusual happened when Turbo arrived to take the train. The usual diesel who brought the train up was nowhere to be seen, and Turbo noticed there were lots of different men checking over the vans in the darkness.
Funny. Why are there so many ground staff tonight?"
He brushed it off as he went to collect the train. Everything went as usual throughout the journey, until he arrived at Mirkum. Usually, he was allowed to wait around whilst the train was unloaded, but found himself being stopped short of the goods platform.
"Turbo? We need you to come off the train here, I'm afraid."
Why?
Operational reasons."
So Turbo was disconnected from the train. Then he was asked to run around to the back and push the train into the end of the siding before being dismissed. But as he left, he watched as more mysterious men arrived and converged on the vans. He returned to the sheds much earlier than everyone anticipated.
"Running ahead of schedule tonight, Turbo."
"And why can't I smell any fish? Have you been bunking off work again? Because if you have, I'm afraid I shall have to consult the authorities about this, you know.
No, I wasn't allowed to stay behind tonight. Operational reasons, apparently. The men who were being weird and secretive, though, was very strange.
Yep, this sounds like the beginnings of a lovely conspiracy theory. Good old Barry knows exactly what's going on here, and it is definitely about sausages.
What are you on about, Barry?
Well, clearly, as Turbo A doesn't stink of those wretched little creatures that lives in the pineapples under the sea, I firmly believe that he skipped work tonight and instead went off to the sausage factory to buy some turnips and cows.
I didn't bunk off work, and I didn't go into any sausage factories.
Well, then, there's definitely something fishy going on here, then. Perhaps you actually brought up a governmental contingency of secret weaponry designed to destroy us all. Or at the very least destroy the carriage sidings because they've been looking at me funny again. I see you over there, you bastards! I did nothing to you, and you have photographic evidence to prove it!
Are you sure it was the fish train, Turbo? They were definitely fish vans.
Then that settles it. There's a cheeky conspiracy going on here. And we're going to have to team up, Avengers style, to find out exactly what silly shenanigans are going on here.
There's nothing going on, Barry. It's probably just for operational reasons tonight, and Turbo said.
Oh, I don't think so. Barry is love, and Barry is a private investigator for this quaint little logging railroad. And I'll find out what's going on here if it's the last thing that I ever do.
Despite Barry's insistence that they would be able to quickly discover what was going on with the fish train, he didn't learn much over the next few weeks. Raymond and Turbo reported no further strangeness as time went on, but Barry was convinced that something was up, and soon took to haunting the station in the dead of night whenever the Red Herring fish train was due in. Weeks later, Raymond was due to bring up the fish train. Like Turbo before, he noticed that, this time, there were different people hanging around the train as he picked it up in Kohapa, and when he arrived at Mirkum, he was stopped just before he entered the station, being asked, like Turbo had, to push the train in for operational reasons. Barry happened to be hanging around at the end of the mainline platforms, and quietly watched as the train was shunted into the goods platform. Once Raymond left, he tried to see what the men were unpacking, but it was so dark he couldn't see them. In any case, he couldn't smell any fish.
Yup. That's intriguing, that is.
Unfortunately, one of the men heard him.
Hey, you! Get out of here! This is private business!
I'm not even doing anything, you delectable piece of beefsteak. What's like you're unpacking anyway?
None of your business. Now go!
You can't make me go anywhere.
Oh yeah?
Go on then, Sonny Jim, fight me!
But Barry felt himself begin to move.
Oi! I'm trying to investigate here!
Orders are orders, Barry. We better get out of the dodge.
You fucking puff.
Barry rolled into the yard and immediately headed over to Turbo and Raymond, who were speaking to Eustace regarding the mystery.
I don't get it. There wasn't any operational need for me to shunt those fish vans into the yard.
Interesting.
And you say there were different lorries there again? That's what I said.
Hey, there really is something going on with those silly fish trains.
What do you mean?
I saw them unloading some mysterious crates of stuff, and then they told me to go away. I mean, how rude is that? Then Driver chickened out and brought me back here faster than Dave when Mr. Dart found his stash of dirty magazines last week.
So, it's not fish in those vans?
Well, I think there's fish in there most of the time. Otherwise you two wouldn't come back smelling like disgusting addicts most of the time. But it seems that some of your trains are carrying some rather interesting brownies, and tonight's was one of them.
But what is it?
I don't know, but I want to find out. It'll be dangerous, full of hijinks and perilous situations, but I'll find the way. Barry always does.
But Barry found out Jackal.
Black Shades.
Barry, how can I help you?
We've come to a bit of an impasse, sir. We want to know what's on those mystery fish trains that those two blower boxes bring up here sometimes.
What are you on about? The red herring's just a fish train.
Oh, no, it isn't. Barry discovered their little secret last night. There's weird little men and crates of something other than fish coming out of those vans on some nights, and we want answers. Not silly answers. Not magic roundabout answers. Proper answers with a nice little Christmas bow on them, if you please.
I honestly don't know what you're on about.
But you're the Fat Controller. You know everything, even the colour of that Mercedes-Benz sat in the car park at Utway. Surely you should know what's being transported on your line.
I don't deal directly with that one, because British Rail bring it to us, and we're just contracted to bring it to Mirkoom. The manifesto for all of these trains have simply been fish.
But those men that were unloading it last night, they were being more secretive than your midget twins.
I don't think it's anything for you or the other to really worry about, Barry. Now go back to work like a good engine.
Oh, but I'm not a good engine. I will find out what's going on here, with or without your help.
Barry soon got a fantastic idea.
Oi, Turbo, Raymond.
What? What?
I've just had a fantastic idea, just like the narrator man said.
And what would that be?
You two cardboard rectangles need to break down.
Oh, easy. Done. You know, I'm not feeling so good myself. I'll have to have a few days off work.
Excellent. Now I shall take your trains for the next few weeks, and we'll see what's what.
Despite Mr. Dark's assurances that a diesel should take the train, Barry somehow convinced him otherwise, and one night, Barry found himself at Kolhapa. And predicted, he had chosen his night well. The train was already waiting for him in the loop, and the ground staff seemed most disapproving of seeing a steam engine taking their train. Barry rolled up quickly, to shouts from the ground staff.
Careful you! This train is fragile!
It's only fish.
That's what you think.
Oh, I know this lot isn't fish. And I'm going to find out what it is.
The staff members walked away as Barry was coupled up. He headed out into the night, being careful to bump the trucks as viciously as he could. Being used to trucks, Barry asked them what was inside them on the way up to Mirkoom, but even they didn't know. And by the time they arrived at Mirkoom, Barry was no closer to discovering what was in the vans. As he approached, he saw a man waiting on the trackside.
Stop right there!
Hey up. We need you to come off the train, for an operational reason, I assume.
Yes.
Well, I don't think so. I'm taking this train into the station and waiting for it to be unloaded. And you can't stop me.
I bloody well can.
No, you can't. The man was surprised to see Mr. Dark walking towards him. I have reason to believe that Barry is right about this particular train. This is highly unusual for such an apparently bog-standard train to have to complete this kind of manoeuvre and, as has been observed by our other engines, some of these services don't smell of fish. As these goods are coming onto my railway, I demand to know what's in these vans. Now then, Barry, bring the train up to the platform. Let's see what's what. So Barry brought the trucks into the station, and Mr. Dark watched as the men began unloading the goods. It certainly wasn't fish. So, what's all this then? The manifesto says this train's supposed to be fish, but clearly, this is not the case. Now, what is it? The man finally gave up.
All right. Usually, this is a standard fish train. However, my boss's company, DARPA Industries, sometimes have to order some unusual materials and bring them in here by rail. However, some of it has to be refrigerated. So we agreed with British Rail to replace the fish with our goods on some trains. We've been experiencing some industrial espionage recently, hence why we disguise our inbound goods as fish sometimes.
Then, why couldn't you just tell us?
Unfortunately, we didn't know if we could trust you or your staff, Mr. Dark. We are still worried about espionage, you see.
Well, I'm finding it difficult to trust you, your company, and British Rail now. We would have happily accommodated a special train now and again if we'd been informed.
As for that, I can only apologise.
I shall need to discuss this further with you and your boss and British Rail now, you understand.
I cannot jeopardize the safety of my engines and staff due to the threat of some alleged industrial espionage.
I understand, and I shall make the necessary arrangements.
Barry was extremely pleased with his discovery, but thanks to Mr. Dark, he wasn't really allowed to tell any of the other engines about it yet, besides Raymond and Turbo. So some of those fish trains are actually special secret goods for DARPA Industries.
That's what Barry said.
So what's going to happen to it now?
Darky Lad says we now have to be told if we're taking an unusual train. Otherwise, we could explode, or be dismembered, or have our earrings eaten by sea monsters.
Well, at least that's settled, and you managed to solve the mystery. 257 would be proud.
I told you, Barry always finds the answer. Now then, I better go and tell everybody about all this.
But I thought you were allowed.
Since when do I do as I'm told? Barry does what Barry wants. Now then, I have secrets to reveal, conspiracies to confirm, and chicken pies to eat. So if you'll excuse me, I'll be on my way.
Raymond and Turbo sighed and Barry ran away.